Hi everyone. So today we will try the red Malaysian guava. So this one is a small to medium size. It can get bigger. It's just the first fruit. So I want to try with you guys. And I'm gonna show you the regular color of the regular guava. So this one is the smallest. It's at the end of the season for the regular guava and the beginning of the red Malaysian guava. So as you see, the color is a little different. So this one a little bit more red tone, and it can get a little bit more red. It just start to get not soft, but a little bit feeling that it's ready. So I cut it and try with you. So let's cut and see the inside. Oh, it's pink color. You see how pretty it is? And let me cut the regular guava for you to see the color differences. So this is a regular guava color, and this one is a pink color. It's called red Malaysian guava. It doesn't smell like guava. It doesn't have the typical guava smell. All right, and it seems to be a little soft in texture, but the color, it definitely is attractive, like a baby pink color. And as you see, I have a little baby pink birthday card, and you see how the color look like. See, it's so pretty. So let's try it. Mmm. The texture is in the medium dense. It's not crunchy, but it's not a soft texture. But it's dense. No bitter taste of the regular guava. I'm gonna remove the seeds. I don't like to eat seeds. But you guys can try it. I will try a little bit after I eat the main guava. It doesn't have a typical smell guava. So I have a plum salt with me right now. I'm gonna try with the plum salt. Mmm. Somehow, I still feel a light slimy kind of feeling. You see this? It's kind of like a soft, sweet guava. Have a little sticky right here. The texture is dense, not crunchy, but not soft. You really have to chew on it. And doesn't have a bitter taste. Not sweet, slight sweet. Neutral taste. No tanginess. No traditional guava taste. The skin. Right here, there's no, I would say, bitter taste of the skin. It reminds me of a, what's it? Definitely have a little slimy in the meat texture. Very, very light tanginess. I would say that is bland to me. I don't feel any kind of wow in there. So I had to dip with the plum salt just to get a little bit more taste. I'm trying to think what is the hard, dense texture in all kind of fruit. I have a taste of like a soft, ripe, barkless pear. That's the only thing I can compare with. But the barley pear is a little softer than this one in texture. So I would say it's a little bit harder barley pear when it's ripe. I can't describe any other center taste in there because I don't feel any. But the color definitely is attractive. Let me try the seed part just to see if it's sweet or sour. Mmm, it's the same as the guava seed. Have a little slimy in the seed area. And the seed of it is almost same size as the regular guava. Here is the regular guava seed. Let me put the red Malaysian and guava. So I don't think the seed any difference in color. But the meat of Malaysian guava is more pink. That's the only attractive one. And the tree is sold in a Home Depot for about $35-$40. It's good to have it if you don't have all the guava tree. But if I have all the guava, I prefer my guava than the red Malaysian. I'm gonna wait it a little bit more into the season to try the decent food. But this one does not impress me yet. All right, except the color. All right, thank you and have a nice day. So this is a red Malaysian guava.